द प्लैनेट मार्स इज ट्रांसिटिंग इन टू द साइन ऑफ कैंसर ऑन द 2nd of June 2021 एंड दिस ट्रांसिट इज गोना हैपन टिल द 20th of July 2021. सो ऑन द 2nd of June 2021 6:52 AM इन द मॉर्निंग द प्लैनेट मार्स प्लैनेट ऑफ फायर द प्लैनेट ऑफ एग्रेशन द प्लैनेट ऑफ एनर्जी द प्लैनेट ऑफ वॉरियर स्पिरिट इज गोना एंटर इन टू इट्स साइन ऑफ फॉल विच इज कैंसर साइन एंड इट इज अबाउट टू रिमेन डेबिलिटेटेड टिल द 20th of July. And this event is going to influence us in a lot many ways because Mars is a fiery planet and Cancer is full of water energy. So what happens when fire is mixed with water? There is a lot of steam, right? So we all are about to be steaming with anger, with frustration, with passion because Mars is losing its own ability, its own nature, and it is forced to behave according to the sign Cancer, which is Moon, which is a water element, and it's very difficult for Mars to thrive here. It is something like a warrior, a army person, or a fighter is asked to come and take care of home, of property, of agriculture, of nurturing, and also the kitchen. So it's a very difficult thing for Mars to do. Now this transit is going to happen in three stages. First, Mars is transiting into Punarvasu Nakshatra from the 2nd of June 2021 till the 7th of June 2021. And during this time, Mars will remain in the Nakshatra ruled by Jupiter. So because Mars will be under the control of Jupiter, so the period will be fine. But from the 7th of June 2021 till the 29th of June 2021, this Mars will be entering into Pusha Nakshatra. Now Pusha Nakshatra, as you know, is ruled by Saturn, and Saturn is already retrograde in the sign of Capricorn, and it is also aspecting its seventh aspect to Mars in Cancer. So it is going to be a very important event. A lot of sparks are going to go around. Even our country is going to face a lot of border disputes during this time, and it is very important for the people who are in authorities to make the right choice. Now this Mars, when it is transiting into Pusha Nakshatra, it is directly under the control of Saturn, and Saturn is already retrograde in the sign of Capricorn, and it is also aspecting Mars in the sign of Cancer. So this is going to be a troublesome period, right? After that, when Mars will enter into Ashlesha Nakshatra, Ashlesha Nakshatra is the nakshatra which is controlled by the planet Mercury, and this planet Mercury is 12th away in the sign of Gemini from Cancer sign. So it is creating loss of comforts. So this Mars, when transiting into Ashlesha Nakshatra also, the period is going to be slightly troublesome. So we will be analyzing this transit of Mars for the 12 ascendants, and this is an ascendant wise prediction. This is not a moon sign or Rashi wise prediction, because ascendant wise prediction is what manifests in the outside world, and moon sign prediction is something which manifests inside you. It is how you feel emotionally within, right? So for Aries ascendant, the fourth house is Cancer sign, and this fourth house is ruled by Moon, and Mars, when transiting into the sign of Cancer, will give a lot of problems regarding to family issues. It will give health issues to your mother. It will give problems regarding property and vehicles, and it will also give you a lot of mental tension and anxiety, because the fourth house is your mind and emotions, and Mars getting debilitated there will create emotional instability in your life. For Taurus ascendant, Cancer falls in the third house, and this third house is the house of brother and siblings and cousins and communications and short distance travel. And Mars getting debilitated into the third house for Taurus ascendant will create strife and misunderstanding between your cousins, between your neighbors, between your friends, your childhood friends. It will also create problems when you do short distance travel, so be very careful, because there are chances of slight accidents, because Mars is also the karaka of bloodshed, so you have to be careful. For Gemini ascendant, Mars is getting debilitated in your second house, and the second house is the house of your family, the house of wealth, the house of saving, the house of lineage. The second house is also the house of the family values which you have gained, and when this Mars is getting debilitated in the second house, it will create problems in your family. There will be discord and arguments and fights between the family. Also, there will be misunderstanding in your family regarding financial matters, because the second house controls the wealth of the family, right? And during this time, you need to be very careful regarding the jewels and jewelries that you have stored in your house, because Mars in Cancer also shows crime, and there are chances of thefts. You have to be very careful regarding that. For Cancer ascendant, Mars is getting debilitated in your ascendant or your Lagna itself. Now, the ascendant of the Lagna is you, your personality, the way you appear in the outside world, your overall health, your vitality, your intelligence. So this Mars getting debilitated in your ascendant will give you a lot of mental tension, will give you a lot of frustration. You will also face health problems, especially you will face problems of the lungs and the chest part, because Cancer sign represents this part of the Kalpurush. So Mars getting debilitated will create problems in this particular area. Also, this Mars will make you passive aggressive in nature. You will start throwing your tantrums and you will start throwing your aggression in front of people, which will be not good for you. So you need to keep check and you need to hold your emotions. For Leo ascendant, Cancer sign falls in the 12th house. Now, 12th house is the house of your bed comforts. It is the house of losses. It is the house of expenses. It is the house of hospitalization. It is the house of jail. It is also the house of foreign settlement. And this Mars getting debilitated in the 12th house will cause problems in you going abroad. It will cause problems in you to sleep peacefully. It will cause problems regarding bed comforts. You will have fights with your spouse in the bedroom during this period. And also it will cause a lot of tension in your, you know, mind level, because the 12th house is the house of your psyche and your mental creativity and imagination. And this debilitated Mars will give a lot of steamy disturbances. It will create strife and problems and discord in your consciousness, because the 12th house is the house of consciousness. Also, during this time, you have to be careful while traveling, because when it will rain, and if you travel outside, then there are chances of you getting struck by a lightning or a thunder. So you have to be very careful about that. For Virgo ascendant, Cancer sign falls in the 11th house. Now, 11th house is the house of your network circle. It is the house of your elder siblings. It is the house of your incoming gain. It is the source of your income. The 11th house is also the house of NGOs and social services and non-governmental organizations. So during this time, when Mars is getting debilitated in the 11th house, it will create problems with your elder siblings. It will create problems with your network circles, that is your friend circle. It will also create problems with the sources of your income. Your relationship with the people who give you income will get spoiled. So you have to be very careful. You have to control your aggression and emotions so that you don't get into strife and arguments with the people with whom you are dependent for gains. You also need to be very careful when you get involved in social activities, non-for-profit activities, because Mars in Cancer shows a passive-aggressive person. So there are chances that you try to help out people in good faith, but the people misjudge your intentions and you get into problems and litigation. For Libra ascendant, Cancer sign falls in the 10th house. The 10th house is the house of your career. The 10th house is the house of your profession. The 10th house is the house of your status. The 10th house is the house of rules and regulations and following the law. The 10th house is the support that you get from government, and also the decision which the judge gives on your favor. That is the 10th house. If you are a Libra ascendant, then you have to be very careful, because the 10th house is actually your social visibility and reputation, and a debilitated planet like Mars transiting in the 10th house, giving you a passive aggressive nature, will make you take wrong decision and wrong choices regarding to career matters, regarding to your social status, and this will cause problems. So you need to be very cautious about it. For Scorpio ascendant, Cancer sign falls in the 9th house. Now, 9th house is the house of your father, your guru, your higher education, your spiritual journeys, your inclination towards God, goddesses, and also your higher philosophy and belief, your religion. So this Mars getting debilitated in the 9th house through transit will cause problems to the health of your father. It will also cause misunderstandings between you and your gurus. It will also cause accident-like situation during religious trips. So don't make any long-distance travel during this period. And also you need to be very careful in regard to the methods which you use while writing your examination, because a debilitated Mars will try to cheat, and if you try to cheat while writing examinations, there are chances that you get caught and you get humiliated. So be very careful and don't let this negative passive aggressive energy of Mars get into you.